Welcome back to War, and the celebration still continues. Craig David just became the new United States champion here on MPWF War. The fourth draft pick of the 2011 draft lottery, and Craig David has won the United States title tonight. I mean, you can see in the elation in Craig David's face how happy he is with his success at becoming the United States champion. You can see Tennessee's out on the floor, out on his feet. He can't believe what just happened. I don't believe what happened. I mean, Jesus Christ, Craig David is the new United States champion. The fact that Craig David is on War is a shock to me. But here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The tag team series continues. And again, that was big. Craig David is now on MPWF War, and he is the United States champion. The California Dragons making their way to the ring. Gray and Victor Dragon will team together to face Satos and Systematic Carnage. Yeah, I just said that, ladies and gentlemen. Carnage and Satos are going to be in tag team action. The winner advances to next week's Fatal 4-Way matchup here in the tag team series. Tonight we already found out that the Super Smosh Brothers have advanced. The team of Reese Bobby and the Cruiserweight champion Hector Rodriguez have advanced. Who will advance in this match? And here are two guys that we've been waiting to see all night. I mean, the question is, will Helios Price come to the ring with them? I mean, what is the deal with them and Helios Price? Are these guys really teaming with Helios Price? Are these guys together? I mean, I guess they are. Look at this. This is eerie as hell right now in the arena. Now look at that. They call themselves the Princes of Darkness. That's just scary. That is sickening. Looking at that, ladies and gentlemen. I'm scared shitless right now looking at these two. Systematic Carnage in all red. Clown Devil Satos. They're commanding in the silence of the crowd. You got Victor Dragon who's shaking in his damn boots, and you can't even blame him. I mean, look at these guys. And they just mean business as they make their way to the ring. I said, I feel sorry for anybody in this tag team series now who has to step in the way and deal with Systematic Carnage and Satos. I mean, they made themselves known at MPWF Starrcade. I mean, Carnage returned. We hadn't seen him since WrestleMania. Since he was chokeslammed to hell, he came and he cost Sean Stevens the Money in the Bank opportunity. We haven't seen Satos since before WrestleMania, but he was taken out. And then he returned and he took out Tendencies. And then they cost Bryan Adams the World Championship. They beat him up before Helios Price cashed it in. And now they're here tonight, and it appears that they're in cahoots with the new World Champion Helios Price, but Price is not with him right now. Yeah, I mean, here they are making their way to the ring to Unholy Confessions by Avenged Sevenfold. I mean, this right here could be the most destructive tag team in MPWF history. These guys are just pure damn scary. And now Satos and Victor Dragon are going to start things off. And Victor Dragon ducking under Satos, trying to duck under him again, but Satos catches him. There's an elbow there by Victor Dragon, and Satos now catching around the waist, and they'll Tommy blow to the back, and what a boot there! What a push boot by Satos. A short jacked mother knocking down Victor Dragon. So he may be short, but he is scary as hell. Look at that big headbutt there by Satos. And now Dre Dragon trying to catch him there, trying to hold Satos away from Victor Dragon. And Victor Dragon now, oh, here comes a double team by the California Dragons. The top tag team of the California wrestling circuit have really been struggling to get back footing here at MPWF War in the tag team division after the Super Sparks Brothers took him out. And now here comes the tag team, the tag into Systematic Carnage. A tag team move going to happen, and Noah off the top rope goes Carnage. The California Dragons really want to put themselves back on top again. Here's a team that they should beat. Here's a team that they can really prove themselves against. And oh wait, look at the strength here of Systematic Carnage as he just throws Victor Dragon on the floor like he's nothing. There's a big clothesline there by Carnage. He's absolutely dominating Victor Dragon in this tag team series matchup. Oh my goodness, we have seen many opponents fall victim to this. Watch this drop kick. Oh! Huge size difference between Systematic Carnage and Victor Dragon, where it is not even fair. And now, oh my god, ladies and gentlemen, Carnage going for the chokeslam already. And a big chokeslam. And then Systematic Carnage knocking Dre Dragon off the apron. And Carnage now going for the cover. And oh, you gotta be kidding me. And that's it. That is it. The California Dragons just got beat in about a minute and a half. And you can see here, look at the destructiveness of Satos and Carnage as they just dominated the California Dragons. We'll be advancing to next week in the Fatal 4-Way matchup. We still have one more team to find out who's going through. And will it be the team of SBM or Sean Stevens, whoever's drafted to war next? And that drop kick down by Systematic Carnage. And right here, this devastating ass chokeslam is what destroyed Victor Dragon. Clearly, when he goes for the pinfall, that's it. One, two, three. Victor Dragon isn't kicking out of that. I mean, who is going to be able to stop Satos at Systematic Carnage in the tag team division? I mean, if they are in cahoots with Helios Christ, who is going to stop these three men? Who's going to stop them from taking over MPWF War? We always hear about Helios Christ talking about how the darkness is going to take over. Well, that's what it seems to be happening right now. I mean, Victor and Drake Dragon both out. Both can't even walk right now. I mean, they're absolutely decimated by these two here tonight.
No, not bang with that.
And here comes a man who's sick in the mind, Vern Mungo, who has made it his personal mission to destroy the life of Joe Eagle. He had Joe Eagle's son abducted a couple weeks back here at MPWF War. Some of the most despicable things I've ever seen in my life. Abducted his son and sent him over to Japan with him. Again, how Vern Mungo got away with that at Customs, I don't know. But Vern Mungo coming to the ring with Lamar James Jackson, and you know he's going to boast and brag about the fact that Joe Eagle was taken out by his client, LJ Squared, at Starcade. I mean, that match barely even began. Joe Eagle wanted to get his hands on Lamar James Jackson. Interrupted the entrance. Was fighting with Jackson on the outside. Had the upper hand until Jackson clipped him with a sledgehammer. And then that was it. Lamar James Jackson decimated Joe Eagle on the outside of the ring. And then threw him in the ring. Got Rich powerbomb him to end the match. And the match held together for about 30 seconds. It was about a 10-minute beatdown at the hands of Lamar James Jackson. So there's one man who's happy about that. And there he is right now standing in the ring, Vern Mungo. Yeah, how could you say that's one of the greatest moments of your life, watching someone get physically destroyed? Only a sick man could say something like that. Intellect and careful selection. That is what he would call it. Guys, an arrogant pig. I mean, maybe it will. Now Lamar James Jackson has something to say here to Vern Mungo. Oh my God. Vile language by Lamar James Jackson. But wait, Lamar James Jackson's, he's talking about Vern Mungo right now. What the hell? Lamar James Jackson just saying that he don't take orders from bitches, as he says. Oh! Jesus! A knee to the face of Vern Mungo. What is this all about? What is this all about? And another knee to Vern Mungo. He's destroying his boss. Lamar James Jackson is destroying Vern Mungo right now, but for what reason? For what reason is this? And referee Marty McFly trying to stop this, but only doing it verbally because he doesn't want to piss off Lamar James Jackson, and something obviously did, as he is now dominating his boss. And this guy, Lamar James Jackson, now, he's become so violent, you care less who he destroys, as long as he's pounding on someone. And we witnessed that at Starcade with Joe Eagle, and now he's taking the fight to Vern Mungo. Now he's destroying Vern Mungo inside the ring. And now, oh my goodness, has him up here. Watch this derailer move. Watch this here. Oh! Jesus. I mean, Vern Mungo is a sick man, but he's old. And he's not going to be able to take a beat down like that. And all Lamar James Jackson, gut-wrench powerbomb. And I mean, this crowd here not respecting Lamar James Jackson whatsoever. And I have no idea what's going through this man's mind right now. I have no idea why he attacked Vermongo, other than the fact that he's trying to prove a point. He's trying to prove exactly how violent he can get, that he could care less about anyone. He destroyed the messiah of the MPWF at Starrcade, and now he just beat his boss, Vermongo, just destroyed him in the center of the ring. I mean, someone is going to have to stop this man at some point. Someone is going to have to stop him in his tracks. Where is Joe Eagle when you need him? But again, like we said before, ladies and gentlemen, this show is fast-paced tonight, and we move on to the final matchup of the tag team series. I mean, still don't forget we have a number one contenders match, the main event in the show, Bryan Adams versus Zack Ryder, ladies and gentlemen. And here comes SBM. Some bad motherfuckers. Jim Jocko and Roscoe Jenkins. The former MPWF tag team champions. I mean, these guys are a hell of a tag team as well. These guys definitely know how to get it done in the ring. And they were tag team champions a year ago at this point. Looking to get back those tag team titles once again. And it's in, they're very confident here tonight. They believe that they're going to win. But the state that Sean Stevens is in mentally and emotionally, and the fact that he has to team with someone from Annihilation, the final draft pick of the 2011 draft for the War brand, SBM thinks they got this one covered. They think they got this one down pat. I mean, you really can't blame their logic. It really seems to down on paper that they do have this one down pat. They do have this one in the bag. But I mean, anything can happen here in the MPWF. That's why it's MPWF War, and it's why it's the best core wrestling action you'll ever see. And this crowd here in Little Rock, Arkansas, still giving a huge ovation for Sean Stevens. They want him to pull through this difficult time he's going through. So, I mean, you got another guy who's going through a difficult time like him, Tennessee's. Tennessee's losing his money in the bank, being attacked by Satos, and then tonight losing the United States Championship. How much worse could it get for Tennessee's? I mean, like we said, the influence of Helios Christ and Carnage and Satos has really affected the entire War brand, and it's affecting each and everybody in their own different ways. Here comes Sean Stevens, and he's trying to show off his confident swagger he usually has, but he really doesn't have it right now. He's really not in the mood for this matchup. I mean, it's going to really take a miracle for Sean Stevens to really fight back tonight. Sean Stevens, he knows what it's like to be tag team champion before. Don't forget, he's a multi-time tag team champion. He's been tag team champion with his brother Lethal Mathematics as a part of the Radar Connection. He's been tag team champion with White Boy Fresh when they were the Masked Murderous Malicious Intent. I mean, he is no stranger to tag team gold. Like Steven said, he can care less if his partner is. He just wants to get this night over and done with. Well, this crowd here in Little Rock, Arkansas are really giving a huge ovation for Sean Stevens. I mean, if Systematic Carnage didn't interfere in Starrcade, I really believe that he would be Mr. Money in the Bank right now. He could have had that World Championship at this very moment. But he's going to have to suck it up and deal with it and press forward here tonight. Again, the anticipation still continues. Who is going to be his tag team partner? Who is being drafted to... Oh my goodness, ladies and gentlemen! You talk about Reunion Central here tonight on Annihilation. Sorry, on MPWF War. Annihilation Superstar Lethal Mathematics is the final draft pick to the night. War may have just destroyed Annihilation's hopes of a roster. The third youngest superstar in the MPWF, the brother to Sean Stevens, is now a part of the MPWF War brand and is going to be a part of this tag team series. I don't believe this at all. This is amazing. This is amazing. This crowd here giving a great reaction to Lethal Mathematics tonight. Now SBM definitely is. Now they're worried. Sean Stevens is teaming with his own brother to challenge this tag team series. These guys are former tag team champions.